I'm standing in front of the CAMI assembly plant in Ingersoll, Ontario, which is about halfway between Toronto and Detroit. It's where General Motors of Canada makes the Chevrolet Equinox and the GMC Terrain. The reason why I'm here is because they've recently hit a milestone that they're quite proud of and want to share the story. What it is they've been able to get this entire assembly plant landfill free. That's right, apparently nothing that enters this plant for manufacturing or anything else achieves or ultimately winds up in the landfill. How do they do that is something I want to find out, so I'm going to go inside, talk with some of the individuals, and figure out just how it works. This should be interesting to find out, so join me and let's go inside.
To be landfill free means all of our waste stream that we generate does not go to a landfill facility. So we look for other ways to reduce, reuse, or recycle our waste stream. To get to the point of being landfill free, CAMI's always had a culture of recycling our waste at the source. So we would have recycling stations, we'd separate our waste stream, and we'd look for ways to to remove waste out of garbage and find a way to recycle them. That eventually led to us having our garbage stream reduced to small portions and recycling being huge, whereas the next step was, all right, let's look at what's in our garbage and say, hey, can we start sending this waste to not a landfill facility, find a place that could reuse some of the energy and benefit the environment that way and reduce our dependence on landfill. Our waste management program starts with us trying to find ways to reduce our waste. So we look for ways where waste can be reduced so that it's not generated in the first place. Our second stage is where we can reuse, so look for ways where the waste can be reused for the same purpose, and then we recycle, so look for facilities that can recycle the waste. Once we go through those three stages, we're down to our last, like less than 5% of our waste, where we divert to an energy from waste facility, so we produce energy from the waste. A good example of an initiative is our weather strip installation that generated rubber material that we needed to dispose, and this used to go into garbage. We looked around for recyclers that could accept the use of this product. We found a recycler in Ohio, and they're able to make this product into playground matting. We're very proud of being landfill free. It's a great achievement for our employees. It's great for the environment, and it also makes great economic sense.
So after taking the tour and learning about the processes involved in making it landfill free, a couple of things come to mind. Number one, a lot of the implementation that was involved in making this facility landfill free came from the input of everybody. There was no top-down hierarchy. It rather involved people from the line right on up giving suggestions. And the reality is, almost all of them were dead simple. It wasn't overly complicated. Some involved a bit of research, but in the end, it really was pretty basic, simple stuff. That's a big takeaway for me. Another is the fact that at the end of it all, sure, this is good for the environment, it's something we all need to do, but it really is a good business decision. This is something that has tangible benefits to the bottom line as well, not just the overall essence of corporate social responsibility. It was an eye-opening experience, and it's one that I hope we'll see a lot more of. This is one of two assembly lines, full assembly lines in GM's North America lineup that does this. I hope to see there's a lot more following, as well as other OEMs across North America as well. That's it from the Ingersoll, Ontario CAMI assembly plant for General Motors on a cold, windy day in November. I'm Eric Novak. I'll see you next time.